Hello everyone, my name is Jerome Page and I'm here this evening to announce a new and exciting project. It's called the 1960s Project, and the theme of the 1960s Project is what's on the minds of the 1960s high school students. If you were in high school during the years of 1960 to 1969, we want you to share your reflections. Join us as we share ours and join into a conversation about remembering, thinking about, discussing, bringing up good times, bringing up not so good times. So tonight I'm announcing the inaugural session, and we will start with the first postings and interviews on Tuesday, September 8th at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So what is the 1960s Project? Again, we want to know what's on the minds of the 1960 high school graduates. So if you were in high school in the 1960s, you could have graduated in 1960, which means that you would have started high school in the 50s, but you've graduated in the 60s. Or if you graduated, say, in 1970, you were in the high school in the 1960s. So we cover a wide range of years and potential audiences. So just wanted to bring my screen up again. Get my controls going here. So we'll be talking about happenings and changes since the 60s. So what have been some of the changes in music? Was the era of, at least the latter part of the 60s, was the era of Motown. Politics, we had the normal kinds of debates between Republicans and Democrats and the unfortunate political situations of assassination of a president, John Kennedy, and then his brother, Robert Kennedy, and then the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. The 60s were highlighted by urban rebellions, and there are echoes of that today. People in the streets marching for justice, for peace, to bring about social change. The first major urban uprising started in Watts, and I believe it was 1963 or 1964. And then for successive summers, there were unrest across many cities. And then after the assassination of Martin Luther King in 1968, there were another round of demonstrations. The demographics changed in the sense that for a lot of urban city centers, like the District of Columbia, where I'm broadcasting it from, the District of Columbia was the first major city to have a predominantly Black population. So there lots of changes. There was a period of continuing trying to desegregate schools in busing. These were highlights of the decade. And then there were all the cultural revolutions, Black power, Black pride, women's rights. The summer of 68, which was known worldwide because it was not only happenings in the United States, but there were student uprisings and demonstrations in Paris and across the globe. So the 60s was a pivotal or an important decade for not just the United States, but globally. And for those of us who were in high school during the 1960s, we were coming of age. So what we'll be talking about is where have they been? Where have we been since the 1960s? I graduated from high school in 1965 from Germantown High School in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. That was 55 years ago. So there's a lot happened in my life over the last 55 years. And now 55 years later, I, like many, are thinking about the next chapter in our lives. There will be remembrances, parties, events, social engagements, concerts, events in high school. People will be reflecting They'll be talking about the meaning of it all, and they'll be sharing their insights into what was going on. So, for example, we have a submission from Gordon, and Gordon graduated from Germantown High School in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, also in the class of 65, my class. I don't remember Gordon in high school. We connected many years later, or just about 4 or 5 years later, 4 or 5 years ago on Facebook, and we started communicating and sharing stories. And his submission, his reflections, was talking about mixing the mystery of life and living. And he'll be sharing, talking about what it was like growing up in high school. And he said what he remembers most is being a truant. And then most of his education didn't come from the classroom, but in fact, it came from interacting with students outside of the classroom, in the sandwich shops and on the streets. So he will be talking about that and how his experiences at Germantown High School set the stage for important advances in his life. So that's what Gordon will be talking about. So then there'll just be other kinds of things that we'll be going into. Then there's one of my oldest sister, Okella Page Trice. She also went to Germantown High School. She was the class of 52. So it'll be interesting to hear how she perceived high school from the perspective of being a Black female, and Gordon perceiving high school on the basis of being a white male. So we get the challenges that my sister faced in terms, if we use current terminology, what the microaggression she had to deal with, and what the implicit bias, racial biases that she had to deal with. So these will be things that she'll be talking about and sharing in her piece that she has submitted for the project. Then there's Subodh. Subodh is an immigrant from India. He went to high school in Jhapar, India. He graduated in December 1966. And after high school, he migrated to the United States, went to college, and launched his professional career. And he'll be talking about what kinds of schools he went to, what his profession was like, and some aspects of his family life. And he'll be highlighting the importance of having two Indian Americans or American Indians from, when we say American Indians, we're talking about Americans of Indian descent. And there are two prominent women who share that. One is Nikki Haley out of either South Carolina or North Carolina, and Kamala Harris, who is the vice presidential candidate along with Joe Biden. So he'll be talking about his life and the advantages he got or received when he was in the United States compared to what advantages he would have had if he had stayed in India. And then there's David Lang. David Lang graduated from high school in 1966, and he headed to Howard University. And he talks about his journey from showing up on Howard's campus in the fall of 1966, and using his terms, he was a white wannabe. His whole image and his whole world was emulating what it was like, what he perceived what white people would be. And that first year on campus at Howard University changed him totally. And so by the end of his first academic year, he went from a white wannabe to someone who was Black and proud. So we'll be dealing with tiny thoughts. We'll be focusing on large memories. So I'm inviting you to start reminiscing. If you would like to submit your tiny thoughts and large memories, please do so. And when the posts start on Tuesday, September 8th, we would like for you to comment on those posts. And as the contributors share their thoughts and others comment on their thoughts, we'll be making new connections in unexpected ways. So our blog postings and Facebook Live start on September 8th. Every Tuesday, there'll be a Facebook Live. And every Tuesday and Thursday, there'll be a Facebook post. So we're looking forward to it, and we're excited. And we hope that you'll tune in on Tuesday, September 8th, and start joining in on, and reading the postings in on September 28th as well. And we'll start this conversation, and maybe even we'll be building a virtual yearbook that covers many, many, many years. So thank you very much, and I look forward to interacting with you on September 8th.